Namaste from TechRama. This is Lakshmi Rajan and I have here the Realme Buds Air New. In case you're planning to buy this, wait, thank me later. So this Air New is priced at ₹2,999. Comes in white, green and red, but right now white is available. That's what I got here today. Backside they have highlighted their features. So it has Bluetooth 5, low latency mode. But hold on to my thoughts on this. Out of the box, you get the Buds case, white color, looks very glossy. Of course, inside you have the Buds, few documents, and then you have here the micro USB cable. So now, this is the Buds Air New case, very compact, so very small and compact, comes with a smooth corners, there's no sharp edges, looks pretty nice in a glossy material. The bottom you have here the micro USB port through which you can charge the case, and in the front you have here the pair button as well as a LED indicator, a single indicator that glows when you are charging, as well as you can find out the battery remaining, because when the battery is full it is a green color, and when the battery is really going down it turns to red. So that's a single indicator you get on this case. Of course, when you open, you have here the Buds, and it has a magnetic attachment and it doesn't fall down also. And you can also see the green light here. Now let's talk about the Buds. So here you have here the Realme Buds Air Neo. So it's like the AirPod design, first generation. Let's talk about the fit. So the fit in such case like this type of earbuds, it may not be fitting everyone the same way. So for me, it fits well. In fact, it's fit better than the Mi Earphone 2, which was launched a few weeks back. And I find personally the fit to be good, but it cannot be the same for your case. And since you don't get any extra ear tips and all, this is a one size that fits for all. You just have to hope that it fits you. And it doesn't go inside the ear canal, so it is a semi-in canal design. So this is how the fit looks. For me, it's fine. It doesn't fall. I can even jog and do my gymming also. I don't have to worry about it. But again, as I said, fit can differ person to person. Now let's talk about the sound quality, which is the foremost thing when you talk about earbuds. First thing which was a dampener for me is that when I started hearing it for the first time, I found the volume level to be really low. I got panicked. What happened to my ears? I mean, not hearing things properly. So immediately I took a different buds which I had, and that sounded well. So there is obviously some issue with the volume level here. So if I am regularly using a 60% volume for my listening, I had to make it for 80% so that I can listen properly on these earbuds. So obviously the volume level is a bit low in these earbuds. That's first part. Second part is the general sound quality of these earbuds. The tuning is not really good. What happens is the mids and highs are not clear, instrument separation is not clear, and overall I didn't like the sound quality. So sound quality for me is a big no, along with the volume level too. First of all, you increase the volume level so that it is audible. In that course, what happens is the highs are really harsh and there's no much audio separation, so you don't really enjoy a proper music in this, especially if you are listening to a very good pair and then you move to this earbuds. You find a different stark difference. This is not the right tuning which they have done here. And then about the call quality, there's a single mic here. Their previous earbuds, I think they had a two mic, but this one has a single mic, and call quality can be termed as decent or okay. I could listen the person who's calling me clearly, but they said that there is some noise in the background. It's not very clean call quality too. It's just an okayish type of call quality you get on these earbuds. So that also is not that great. One thing it excels well is though on the low latency mode. So you can hold the both the earbuds for 2 seconds and it switches over to low latency mode or game mode. And when I played PUBG and the low latency mode is good and I don't see much lag when you play, and you can play PUBG and things with these earbuds and you'll be fine. So low latency mode for gamers is good, but then the sound quality for music is not that great. About the controls, so it works on a touch or tap you can do. So double touch or triple touch functions are there. You can play, pause music, answer incoming call, end a call, change tracks. And the best part, they have an app, Realme Link app, where you can remap these functions. So the two touch as well as the three touch can be remapped. So instead of two touch for play and pause, you can do two touch for changing the next track on your right or left. So this way you can customize the touch functions. That is a very good option they have given in the Realme Link. Battery, so they claim to get 17 hours of battery life in this, and I have not gone through the entire 17 hours which you get in the case in together, but with my experience with the earbuds, when the company claims 17 hours, you should be getting 15 to 16 hours at least. And in this one, single charge on earbuds, you get around close to 4 hours. So that's about the battery life. It's decent enough on the battery life. So should you buy this Buds Air Neo or not? To frankly, if you ask me, no. Why? Sound quality is not that great. Tuning is heavier and volume level is low. And the game mode is good. So only if you are buying this for gaming, that's fine. But you are not just going to, you'll be also listening to music, and music is not that great. So that's my honest review of the Realme Buds Air Neo. So in case you're planning to buy, just keep all these things in your mind and then proceed with it. Still, if you want to buy, the link is there in the description. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. This is Lakshmi Rajan signing off for Tech Roman. Have a great day. Cheers.